Hello and welcome to the North Ipswich Reserve. There's a rainbow out the back. There's a big crowd in attendance. We are here for the Mayor, Paul Pasali, A-grade Cup Grand Final between Brothers and Goodna. I'm Chris Bombalis. I'm joined by Ben Dobbin. And Dobbo, mate, what a great afternoon for footy.
Yeah, rugby league in Ipswich is alive and well. A big crowd on a Saturday afternoon. It doesn't matter about the weather because I tell you what, they're here to see this clash. Brothers taking on Goodna. Goodna, the minor premiers, and it will be an absolute battle. Have Brothers who have been successful in the 18s, 19s, and also the reserve grade today. They are a huge chance of having a clean sweep here at North Ipswich Reserve. But you know what? Rugby league's the winner, mate. Let's just hope we get a good, clean game. It doesn't degenerate as what we have seen in the past. It's rugby league, and let's enjoy it.
And the conditions, we've had a bit of rain here. Let's not kid ourselves. It's a bit damp underfoot. We don't want another downpour because conditions aren't too bad. And there's been some good skills already shown today.
Yeah, there certainly has. I tell you what, we should get a weather update. Down on the sideline for the first time this afternoon, the head sports journalist, the sports editor, the chief de beers of the QT Times, Ben Wilmot. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, boys. Well, you picked the best spot to be commentating this game from. Unfortunately, it has been torrential this afternoon, but it's starting to let up now, and we're hoping for a let-off during the A-grade game, that's for sure.
Yeah, we've all had our turn on the sideline, brother, so don't think you've got to do your stripes on the sideline before you get up into the commentary box, mate.
But he looks good in the QT dries a bone, though, doesn't he? Hey, yeah. Good shape.
Ben, you've been around both these sides a fair bit this year. What's your tip?
Well, I've got to say the Goodna Eagles have deserved the title of minor premiership holders this year, and they're going to be the side to beat, I think.
Yeah.
It's their first grand final since 2013, but their opponents, the Brethren, they've been around for a long, long time. And the last 10 grand finals, they've been beaten in the last two, Brothers, so they want to win today.
Well, they're called the grand final specialists for a reason. They know how to win a final. They've got a very disciplined pack and a great coaching staff behind them. But as I said, the Goodna Eagles, led by the big Ramon Philippine, he's gotten the A-grade player of the year, IRL player of the year for a good reason, and he's going to be the man to lead them forward today.
Here come Brothers out onto the field, and
have a go with the number six, Sam Kruger. Fair dinkum. He looks like a tight head prop playing for the Wallabies tonight. He'd be in a Wallaby jersey.
I hope he can lock down a scrum then.
He's a ball player. That's it. Catch and pass. Put him into gaps.
Ah, yes. Brothers out onto the field first. And the crowd, big anticipation here. The referees, I can see them just about ready, Dobbo.
Yeah, look, I think a great initiative is that the one thing about rugby league is we're not discriminatory. Belinda Sleeman has had plenty of NRL experience on the sideline. She's a Queensland Cup, Intra Super Cup referee. She will be officiating today. And I spoke to her earlier. She is ready for it. She's so excited. And one of the up-and-coming stars of rugby league.
Female referee to referee O'Rell A-grade grand final. So congratulations to her to running out today.
Yeah, that is huge. That is huge. And look, she's a really lovely young lady and just loves the game of rugby league. Been really supportive. She just said to me, look, I just hope it's a really good game. This is the only game she's got this weekend. I've seen her on the sideline plenty. She was on the sideline against the Roosters 2 weeks ago when the Roosters took on the Brisbane Broncos two Thursday nights ago. Like, so she's a qualified official. And look, there was a good roar for the Brethren, and they're pretty fired up. But you wait to hear this roar when the Goodna Eagles turn out.
It's great to be part of history with a female referee, I've got to tell you. And also, it'd be great if we don't talk about the officials at the end of the match. We are talking about a great game of football where one side prevails over the other because of great football. And that's what we're looking forward to. We can see a guard of honour waiting for the minor premiers to come out here. And they've got the wood on Brothers this year. They've beaten them three times. The best that Brothers have done against the Eagles is a draw, Ben. So form says Goodna.
Well, that game, actually, Brothers had that game in hand. It was only Goodna scoring in the last couple of minutes that brought that back to a draw and saved a loss. But that's why they finished minor premiers, is because they've pulled through those tight games and been able to pull the stops out when they really needed to.
Yeah, final instructions obviously being given now to the Goodna Eagles before they make their way. And a little bit of sportsmanship and gamesmanship here. Brothers have now been out onto the field for about 3 to 4 minutes. The siren's gone, and they're just waiting now. So do they start warming up?
Oh, I think the Brothers runner's been out with water a couple of times. That's how long they've been waiting.
So that's the second siren warning. You got to love Ipswich Grand Finals. Hey, you are watching the IRL A-grade Grand Final on Phoenix Media Hub, along with the APM Network in partnership with the Queensland Times. Chris Bombalis, Ben Wilmot and Ben Dobbin with you. What a game of rugby league we've got. And have a listen to the roar now as the Goodna Eagles make their way out onto the field.
I think the grounds are starting to shake now, boys. As Big Ramon carries his kids over the mud puddle to get over through into the line and lead the Goodna Eagles out for the grand final match against the brothers Ipswich.
And Rapon Philippine, what a gentleman he is. A gentle giant, quietly spoken, but gets the job done.
He's a big unit as well, and they are a big side.
Is that the key today, if brothers are to win, to run these big blokes around?
Well, they're going to have to spread it. The Broncos play that kind of theory as well. They're not the biggest side, so they play that quick, up-tempo style, and trying to change it around. Obviously, brothers in a huddle now. Goodna to make their way out onto the field, which suggests to me that we could be all upstanding here for the national anthem here. Saturday afternoon. I'd like to ask Ben, how long's it been since we've had a Saturday afternoon grand final? Is this the first time ever? Because I've been part of a few grand finals here that have been a Sunday afternoon.
Well, it's actually a return to history. It was the last time was back in the 50s, I've been told, from Jan Christensen, one of our historians on the topic here in Ipswich Rugby League. And yeah, it is a bit of a return to tradition. It's been 50 years since it was last played on a Saturday, and it kind of facilitates the modern kind of game and the modern families that you're kind of dealing with. They've got a Sunday to recuperate and don't take the time off work on a Monday for silly Monday celebrations.
I don't think it'll stop a few of them.
And we're about to have a moment's silence for the tragic passing of a long-time supporter and sponsor of the Goodna Eagles, Ray Jackson, who died this morning. The crowd will stand at attention and offer the family and friends of Ray their condolences. Moment silence over, the national anthem. You can see the emotion on the Goodna Eagles. This is an emotional charge day for them.
Nothing better than the Australian anthem at Ipswich. Saturday afternoon, Rugby League, the IRL Grand Final. And we are not far away from kickoff.
And Goodna. Ben, let's go to Ben on the sideline. Ben, how was that? The emotion in the Goodna players was unbelievable.
Well, I don't know if you saw the colourful characters off to the side here, but they've been all decked out. Everyone's been here since early morning. Even the kids are jumping into the water pit that's suddenly erupted on the side of North Ipswich Reserve. Lucky it's not on the field itself.
Well, all I can say is bring it on, Ben. Bring it on.
It's definitely going to be a great matchup between two great teams, and with brothers getting two grand final wins already on the trot, they're going to be hard to beat as well.
And we are underway. The kickoff. It's a shallow kick, but it bounces a long way, and we're into the first hit up of the grand final for 2016 here in Ipswich. Brothers in possession, working it away from their danger zone. They get it to about 15 metres away from the halfway line on tackle two. Again, brothers looking to work their big forwards. Another 10 metres up the middle. 14 takes the ball up, and that's Trevor Exton. Kick early in the tackle count. Obviously, in the wet weather, they want to play the football. Good have kick. It all down in Goodna's territory, and a good job there from Joel Bennett to get out of the in goal.
So Goodna now with the first opportunity this afternoon. A great set by the brothers who are putting plenty of pressure on this Goodna Eagle side. That's going to be on the defence. Boccia straight into it straight away. Making plenty of hard work, young Jack Boccia. So now they work up with Lemberg. He makes a strong carry up towards the 20, and they're up over the 20 metre now. Goodna making good yards as they work down that left-hand side.
Tanaloo it was.
No score as they work back in the middle. Oh, great defence as well. And that's going to be a penalty just inside. So they're a little bit excited at the moment, this Goodna team. And boy, oh boy, hasn't this started a frenetic pace?
It certainly has. And the crowd waiting in anticipation. The two form sides, they finished 1-2. Goodna had the best of it during the 2016 fixture rounds, but this is a whole new ball game. They were successful in the qualifying final, beating Brothers 38-28. A mistake, so Brothers will get the pill now and work it away from their own line.
Yeah, this wet weather is obviously playing a little bit. So Brothers now just short of the 40. They start to wind up and work down the centre of the field with a strong carry. So they're almost to the halfway, and another mistake. But the referee, Belinda Sleeman, says, get your hands out of it. And Brothers will get their first penalty for this afternoon. Well, Bomber, jeez, both sides are making mistakes early.
Bit of grand final nerves there. And I don't know if that was a penalty. Dead set. The Brothers ball carrier juggled the ball and slipped out. Got to give consideration for the conditions.
Leisman drove the ball towards the 40-metre line, western side of the field. No score. Brothers Goodna as early as now Haynes takes a short side. Well, it was a knock-on by Goodna, so it'll be six more. So it's gone backwards, so there will be a knock-on. Scrum loose head and feet, I would say. Brothers will get the ball and a good opportunity 40 metres out from the Goodna try line.
And I'll tell you what, in the reserves, we saw an actual try come from a scrum push, so we might get some action in the scrums today, Dobbo.
Yeah, we certainly will. So Leisman standing at first receiver, the number one, along with Fatoi, the number four, as now they start to work. Connors went across himself and shoveled it off to Heck, and he's brought down now 30 metres out centre field. Haynes barking for a quick play the ball, shoveled it off to the right-hand side, and this is where Brothers are starting to work nicely now. 25 metres out centre field, a good opportunity for the Brethren. They shape to the right-hand side. Kruger holds up, dumps it back inside to Boccia. He offloaded now. This is play on. Kruger with the ball, looking dangerous now. Heck, he almost goes through, and he's brought down now 12 metres out. A good opportunity with Brothers as they open up the open side to the left. It comes across to Kruger. Kruger comes across now to the 14 in Exton, and he's brought down now 8 metres out. Brothers right on the attack. No score. Goodna Brothers. So now, slow play the ball. They shovel it across. They change direction to the right. They open it up. It's offloaded. It comes across now to Kruger. He steps, dances, shimmies, goes to the line. Still going. And I think he got there. No, he didn't. It's a little knock on, held up. So great work by Brothers early. And Sam Kruger, the number six. No score. Goodna, Brothers.
He must have been held up just millimetres short. He'll go back and play this. You got one tackle left in this set. What'll they do with it? Little kick in behind. No, they're going to run it on the last. They come out to the left-hand side. Ball's gone down. That'll be a changeover. And it's play on now because Goodna have got the ball and working it away from their 10-metre line. You're right. Plenty of drop ball at this early stage. Bit of nerves, bit of conditions. They're going to have to respect the ball a lot more, Dobbo.
Would you believe the sun's starting to come out now? We've had torrential rain here for the last hour prior and a mistake by their captain, which has caused another opportunity for Brothers 25 metres out from the try line. We'll go down to the sideline. Ben Wilmot.
Well, this is where the experienced head of Jason Connors in the number seven for Brothers is really going to come out. He's a man with a lot of experience. He started the season as just supposed to be the coach for the club this year, and he got put into the halves when they had a couple of injury scares, and he's really brought the Brothers back to the fold.
Yeah, he's got the hands on the ball now. Connors, he goes across, and this is where they're dangerous, to the number four. He's fending everywhere at the moment for Toai.
He's the IRL's Rookie of the Year as well.
Lawyer for Toai. So they work back towards the middle now. The Brothers doing it nicely with their number 11 in Umu, making good yards. 12 metres out, western side of the field. They open up the right. Haynes barks her instructions. He shovels across and it works back across now to O'Doherty, wearing the headgear tonight, wearing the number 8. The big bustling front rower. Haynes shovels to the right-hand side. Long ball to Connors. Connors finds Kruger. Kruger looking to chance up. Holds it up and goes outside to Leisman, but they were marked up and they brought him down beautifully. They're going backwards at the moment, Brothers. Quick play the ball. Hexton, he turns around. The 14 comes back to Leisman. This is better play. This is where they're dangerous. Amu goes across now. It goes across to the young IRL Rookie of the Year in for Toai. Dangerous at the moment, Brothers, as they change direction. Connors, little grubber kick. They come flying through. They're dancing everywhere. Did he get there? I don't think he did. It's back to the 20 for a restart. 7 set. They're putting plenty of pressure on them at the moment, Brothers.
Yeah, just can't get over the line. That was a good little chip in behind and a good chase, but unfortunately the ball just rolled out. Now it's up to Goodna to roll up the sleeves and get the ball, get a roll, get up the other end. We've had most of the play inside the Eagles' half. There's a good charge from the number 11, Tanalu, and he gets it up to within 8 metres of the halfway line. Now a dart out of dummy half. It's the winger in Alexander to Peasy, and he goes up a further 10, 12 yards, and away they go again. Good dummy half running. They're on a roll, and the ball's gone. Referee says that's a penalty. You rake that out.
Yeah, it was a strip, and they're going to play on quickly, Goodna, as they quake a quick tap, and they're all offside. Brothers, plenty of pressure now. Bomo, I can feel some points starting to rain in. Oh, they're all over the ruck, and what does Belinda Sleeman say? That's another penalty. Somebody could go to the bin here. Well, it's probably not a bad tactic by Brothers. Do you take the 2 points, but you're on a roll here at the moment, Goodna? I don't know if they've got the 2 points in them.
It's the first time down here and they've taken a tap. They don't want two. They want 6. And a charge comes up. Ione. He's only about 5 metres away from the line. They're stretched across the paddock. It comes left. It comes to the right. I beg your pardon. And stepping, weaving, dodging the captain, Ramon Philippine. He's within a couple of metres of the line. Big chance here for first points this afternoon in the 2016 Grand Final in Ipswich. Knock on here. No, they say knock back. It's gone back to Brothers, and so Brothers now get to work it away from their line.
Boy, oh boy, a lost opportunity there. So Brothers now, Leisman into dummy half, and the wingers will go to work now with Brock Elridge making it out and bringing it off his own line. So they work to the centre of the field. Brothers, their first really opportunity in defence, and they've come up. Here's the big number 8, Jake Doherty, bustling up the middle towards that 30-metre line. No score, 9 gone in the first half of the IRL Grand Final. Brothers versus Goodna, as now they work to that right-hand side. A better play, a loose ball as well. And there's mistake after mistake coming through. The ball still picked up. They're away now, Goodna. They step over one, step over two, and finally Leisman brings him to the ground.
Great hands, great pickup, and now they've got an opportunity. Can we see the first points in the first half? We're about 10 minutes into the grand final, and it's now the Eagles deep on attack. The minor premiers looking to crack open the brethren. So far, both defences have stood firm. We've had a few mistakes, but the lines are held intact. It comes out to the right. Deep attack now, and it comes across. And there's a cutout ball. It comes to the 15, and he's away. Can he get there? Yes, this could be the first try. Oh! I think he got across the line, but lost control.
No try. Lost control. And I tell you what, that's a lost opportunity. Ratu Waknavalu made a real mistake, the number 5. So Brothers have held on twice now.
Golden opportunity, that one in the corner. Just had to hang on to it, really. Momentum was going to get him there, Dobbo.
Doherty offloaded, and this is where they're dangerous. They're making easy yards up the middle now as Brothers come up towards the halfway on their second tackle. Haynes into dummy half, opens up the right, works it up the middle now to a big, bustling number 13. And a mistake again. Denimayu. So he's had a good start to the game, but just a little error, the front rower, and we've got an injury. And this game has started at a frenetic pace.
Absolutely. Both teams taking an opportunity to get in some breaths, suck in the oxygen. Trainers are out there barking instructions. I wonder what both coaches will be thinking right at this point. Let's go down to the sideline. Ben, how have you seen it from the sideline point of view?
Oh, frantic pace so far in the first, 10 minutes so far. A lot of drop balls, and unfortunately that's the conditions they're going to be playing in all day. It's going to come down to which team can hold onto the ball and make the best of it.
Absolutely, and we've seen promising attacking rates from both sides. Lines holding strong, and just the last little bit, Dobbo, they just can't seem to get the ball down.
So Goodna with the opportunity now. Maliki Olitoa will feed the ball as they work to that left-hand side. And it's with Saw Manatafa, the number 13. So they work back. Kirk works back now to the Lemberg, and they're making good yards. Quick play the ball. They shape. They turn it back inside now. Goodna making easy yards up the middle, and they're 10 metres out. No score. They're on the attack.
Ione, let's go to the sideline. Ben's got some news.
Yeah, it looks like big Jack Botcher, he's come off to the sidelines already. He's clutching his arm. It might be a broken arm here on the sidelines, and that's going to be a big loss for Brothers today.
Huge loss. That is bad news, as now the Eagles are deep in attack. A little chip kick through. There's a chaser coming through. Claims they got there. Referee's checking with the sideline. Says it's a knock on.
Joel Bennett has butchered that, the number one. Oh, so that is the third opportunity now, Bomber. Hang on, there's a little bit of discussion. So it's going to be a line goal dropout here. So let's just have a quick look at that. They came through, there's a knock on. So this is going to be a line goal dropout. And Goodna are going to get the opportunity. Well, I don't understand that decision. But it is play on. Brothers hold on. Leisman drives the ball long, 40 metres out. Lemberg winds up. Look at this freight train go. But the defence met him in a beautiful hit as well. Goodna right on the attack. They've had the possession. It works back now. Oh, the number six and Olitoa. Oh, and there's another mistake. Somebody's going to go to the bin here, Bomber, very shortly. Professional fouls.
Oh, I reckon the referee will start to lose a bit of patience here. What do they do? Do they keep going the tap? Yes, they do. We can see Talapau is now giving the ball to his captain, and Philippine takes the ball to within 18 metres of the line. Looking for our first points in the 2016 Ipswich Rugby League Grand Final. They go wide again, another bad ball, and it's gone to ground, and Brothers will come away with it.
Ipswich haven't got into the opposition half for the last 6 minutes, as now they work off their own line. Doherty now, the big bustling forward. He's going to play a few more minutes with the injury to Botcher. He gets up and plays the ball. Leisman holds on. They work now that short side up towards the 30-metre line and over. So good yards by Brothers on the third, as now they come back to the open side. And here's the front rower wearing the number 13, Denham Ayu. Up over the 40-metre line. Playing good metres. There's great defence by Goodna as they're trying to keep this Brothers side in their own half. As now Connors says, we're going to get out of here, and puts the ball on the toe. And it's taken beautifully by the number five in Waknavalu as he works back and tries to link up with his fullback in Joel Bennett. No score. 27 to go first half. Ipswich and Goodna.
Yeah, we've had plenty of forward work here, and we're looking for the outside backs to get involved. And this is Waknavalu who takes the ball up to the 30-metre line. We seem to have had a lot of play in between the two 30-metre lines. Both sides looking to get on top of each other, not getting the ascendancy. Goodna, though, have had the best of the chances. Here's another drop ball. Referee says no. It was a strip. And we'll have another penalty to Goodna, and the minor premiers can kick themselves into an attacking position once more.
This penalty count is very one-sided at the moment, and Brothers need to be really careful. I think they've had one penalty compared to now six penalties for Goodna. And boy, oh boy, it's not going to be long before the referee will go to the pocket if this continues on. So Corey Kirk now will drive this ball to the eastern touchline and bring it 35 metres out, right on the attack, Goodna. You're watching the IRL A-Grade Grand Final on the Phoenix Media Hub, along with the APN Network in partnership with the Queensland Times. Hope you're enjoying the coverage wherever you are. And there's another mistake. So this weather's starting to play. Hang on, there's a bit of push and shove here now. And this is what we thought, frustration starting to creep in, and it was a mistake by Goodna in that first carry. Boy, oh boy, they'd be disappointed with that outcome.
Oh, absolutely. They had a golden opportunity, almost a full set to attack with. They spread the ball to the left-hand side, had a nice back line set on the right side for a strike, and then first tackle, ball goes to ground. Now, what can Brothers do with it? They're going to try and work it away from their own danger zone. 10 metres gained there by the winger, and he goes down. And
young Seve, Ben Seve, playing in the number two, a late inclusion. His brother Marion, part of the Broncos fabric this year.
Got to remember that James Haynes, also a late inclusion for Brothers.
As they work now. There's a high shot there, but the referee didn't see that. So Haynes, the number nine, he worked back to this left-hand side. Connor's getting his hands on the ball. That's better play by Brothers as they work up the middle now with the number 13, AU. 30 metres out. They shift it now. They come to the right-hand side to hold up Leisman. He double pumps, holds it back now, and he's brought down. So they're making good metres now, 20 metres out, right on the attack. Haynes looking for a runner, finds Connors, who's got involved very quickly. He puts a short kick, but it's going to have too much heat on it. Back to the 20 for a restart. So both sides, especially Brothers, when they get their hands on the ball, are looking dangerous. It's just that final kick, final pass that is costing both teams at the moment. No score, 24 to go in the first half.
Yeah, finishing touches are costly for both sides. Now let's see what the Eagles can do. I reckon a couple of repeat sets on the trot could crack either of these defensive lines at the moment. There's a couple of big boppers out there, Dobbo, that are starting to get a bit tired. And I reckon, oh, there's another mistake. And now Brothers are on the attack. Can they counter swiftly? They go down the right-hand side. They've got opportunity here. And they're tackled right on the 20.
And there was a strip there, but the referee says, yes, there was. So Brothers finally get an opportunity. Well, this will be interesting, Bomber. Do they play on?
My word, they do. They've taken the quick tap. I would have thought maybe Leishman a quick shot at goal. He got 8 from 8 last week.
Haynes now into dummy half, looking for a runner. He's Connors Barks instructions. He gets his hand on the ball, double pumps, took it himself. The crafty little number 7, and he's brought down 5 metres out centre field. Here Brothers go. Will they be the first to post points in this grand final? They head to the left. Leishman holds up. This is where they're dangerous. They go for the line, and they'll score.
The number Lola 4.
Fetioi. And he scores for Brothers, 4-0, kick to come, Bomber. They did it easily in the end.
Good finish. He twisted in the tackle, and he was too hard to hold up. The defence couldn't get underneath him and hold him up. And he cracks open the first try of the afternoon. So Brothers post first points in the 2016 Ipswich Rugby League Grand Final.
Lawyer Fetioi, he did it well. They went to that left-hand side, and he got his hands on it. Josh Leisman, he got his hands on it, double pumped and put him into a gap. And it was a nice ball in the end. He had a little bit of work to do. And Brothers would be really happy with that. They've defended well. They had that sets of six, repeat sets of six by the Goodna side. And Brothers now go to a 4-0 lead with a kick to come, 22 to play in the first half.
And well done to the young centre. Good finish, as you said, Dobbo. He's the IRL Rookie of the Year. Strong and rips in. And we got a great example of that then. And I'm looking forward now to the conversion attempt in the wet. It's going to be hard. He's almost a couple of metres in from touch. He's brought it back to about 21 metres away from the posts. Leishman, as I said, got 8 out of 8 in the qualifying. He was quiet in the qualifying final, but in the prelim final, 8 out of 8 with a boot. This will be a tough ask first kick of the afternoon for goal.
Yeah, western side of the field and for any goal kicker, no matter what. But throwing about half an inch of rain in 10 minutes. Just to add, lights are on here at North Interest Reserve.
I wonder if we go down to Ben. You back it in or out? Ben, come on.
Oh, 8 from 8 last week. You've got to back him, don't you?
Well, it's his preferred side. So he comes in now. He's a lefty.
Let's see how you two wise gentlemen go here. Nostradamus of goal kicking. Here we go, Leishman. 8 out of 8 last week. He'll looking to keep around that run to 9.
No, he doesn't. It's like no a goal swing. He pulled it across the post. So 4-0 Brothers, an early leader now. Well, I'm surprised. Goodna have had the opportunities, and it's been there just at their final touch where they've made the mistakes at the present moment. And these big forwards, we talked about this, whether or not the wet was going to hinder the Goodna side, this big pack that they've got at the moment.
And Ben, I can see a couple of the interchange players warming up down here. I see the 17 for Brothers, Isaac Creedy. He's looking to get on. The 16's there as well, Matthew Kuss.
It looks like Botcher's standing up as well. He's checking the arm out.
Well, that's a good sign for Brothers. You don't want to be a man down, you know, in a grand final with, what, there was about 70 minutes to go when he came off.
Especially losing your co-captain. That's a big loss in the leadership team.
All right, now it's Brothers with the ball, having posted first points. They work it into Goodna territory, and a big hit up there. Big contact there from some big forwards, including Jake O'Doherty, the number eight for Brothers.
So O'Doherty plays the ball. Haynes in the dummy half, goes to Connors, who's really got himself involved, put a little deft kick, but it was picked up beautifully by Tupos, the number two, and he worked back to the centre of the field. So Goodna now with an opportunity with their captain, who crunched up the middle.
It'll be interesting to see how they respond, Dobbo.
Yeah. Talapu in the dummy half. He found the number eight in Zach Lemberg as they just make a quick play the ball. He got the offload. So this is where Goodna are trying to get out of trouble, and they don't need to panic. Under 20 to play in the first half. Brothers lead by 4-0. The ball now with Ione. Perry Ione, the number 10, making good yards up towards that halfway line. And they just need to start completing their sets and getting back to this game plan that won them the minor premiership now. Kirk with the ball, drove it high. It was a good kick as well. But Josh Leisman was there to pick it up, and he took it beautifully and works back towards the centre of the field, up to over the 10-metre line towards the 20. 4-0, Brothers over Goodna.
Big lanky fullback got it to the 20-metre line, and he tried a little bit of a goose step. It looked very spectacular, but didn't get him too much ground. That's a hit up from the try scorer for Toya. He gets it to within 30 metres of the halfway line. As now the number two, oh, he had to pull up. Yeah, he had to pull up because he was going to do the good old shepherd and thought, I better take this tackle, not run in behind my own teammate. Now we get another hit up. Good strong run this time. The number 16's out there now, Matthew Kuss, as we suspected. He was warming up for about 10 minutes. I reckon he said to the coach, Coach, I'm ready, mate. I'm ready to get out there. The 11 now takes it up as well. That's Umu. He gets it just inside Eagles territory.
Yeah, doing it nicely now, Brothers. And they're starting to get the run of it now. Kruger gets the ball, drives it along the carpet lightly, and it's picked up. Waknavalu took it nicely, let it come to him and picked it up and just waited beautifully. And so now, Goodna with an opportunity as they work off their own line. The ball now with the number 15 in Ione.
I've got to say, there's a few forwards slow to get back on side for the Eagles. Not a good sign early on in the match.
Saw Manatafa now. Work back towards the middle. Oh, a little bobble as well. And a great run, though, by Ione. Perry Ione takes him up over halfway now. They drive the ball on the fifth. And Leisman will have to run back along with the number five in Eldridge. He picks the ball up right on his own try line. And Brothers now will have to come 100 metres if they are to post points. So Leisman now looking for a runner as they work up that middle now. And they're looking dangerous as Brothers now. Great run by the try scorer. In for Toi up towards the halfway. Well, that was a 30-metre run, so they're doing it nicely now.
Good roll on here from the brethren as they punch it up towards the 10-metre line. They're 39 metres away from the try line, and they certainly have settled down now. We've had a lot of mistakes early on, and now they're getting into a groove, and they make a good break down the right-hand side. The number three takes the tackle in Caleb Heckey.
Heckey with the ball, Seve in the dummy half. They open up this left-hand side. Seve takes it from dummy half and makes darting metres now on that eastern side of the field. So they set nicely, Brothers. Hayne into dummy half. Comes a long ball to Kruger. Kruger finds Connors. Connors opens up, turns it out the back to Leisman. Leisman goes out the backside. This is where the dangerous goes across now to Vatai. And he'll score a double. And Brothers are in again. It was a pet play. And Bomber, they are starting to run hot on this Goodna side.
Oh, they've got this right-hand side defence in twos and threes. And that was a simple backline move where they just held up, held and passed. And great finishing work from Fatoi.
So he gets a double. And we now know why he's the IRL Rookie of the Year. He just positioned himself, but it was a great ball. And I've got to wrap the number seven in Jason Connors, who is just obviously the captain coach, but he really stepped up. They were a little bit overwhelmed early by this Goodna side. They weathered the storm, and that great run by Fatoi, who got them out of jail when they made 30 metres, and then they've come back, they've opened up the left-hand side, and they've posted points.
Great finish.
And Josh Leisman will almost take this kick in the identical position of where he took the last one. Ben Wilmot on the sideline.
We've got a couple of tired Goodna forwards coming off now. That's a frantic pace, mate. Yeah. How was the first half for you?
Yeah, pretty quick. We've just turning over too much ball at the moment. So, as long as we hold on to some pill, we'll be right. Just got to get some back.
Excellent. Well, there's a word from Zach Lemberg coming off the sidelines. He's the big number eight for Goodna, and he's done a great job in the first opening spell. But we'll turn to Josh as he goes for the kick conversion.
You know what, Bomber? I have never been able to interview one player in 8 years of commentating football as they walk off. Ben Wilmot, I congratulate you, mate. You're on fire down on the sideline. You're never coming to the commentary box.
We are not there to stay. Worthy. Yeah, you are there. Yeah,
you are there, mate.
I've earned the call up.
Comes in, strikes at it. This time it looks better. Just pushes across to the right-hand side. 8-0. So kicks will be crucial by the end of it. Under 15 to play. Brothers doing it nicely over Goodna.
Got to say, that's great access to Zachary Lemberg as he's coming off, having a breather. You could hear he was out of gas, and he still took time to talk to Ben on the sideline. Although I don't reckon he had any choice, because Ben basically was going to trip him, wasn't he?
You know what I like the most about it is, if it happened in the NRL, there's every possibility that the F-bomb would come. He was as clean as clean. Then it was just absolutely beautiful.
I pick my targets well.
Yeah, well, you know what you're doing. You're a lot gamer man than me.
And he goes to a player on the side that's down 8-0 as well. No, he doesn't go to the side that's up 8-0. Well done, mate. You've a lot of fortitude. Now let's see the hard work again from Brothers. And as I said earlier, they're getting into this groove. They're starting to open them up down the middle. And there are gaps appearing. And this is alarming signals for Goodna. As they're down by 8-0, there's 14 minutes left in this first half of the 2016 grand final, and almost getting through was Leisman.
Yeah, Connor's into dummy half now. Look, geez, he's dangerous. He plays the short side, goes across now. This is where they're dangerous to the number four again. He is absolutely terrorising them down on this left-hand edge at the moment. Haynes into dummy half. Opportunities now for Brothers as they work to the open side, the right. Leisman playing first receiver, goes across to Kruger. Kruger puts it on the toes. Seve coming wide through. He goes up for it. The ball loose on the deck, and they'll score. They'll point to the spot and they'll get another try. And it's Heckey who scores the try from a great Sam Kruger kick. Brothers 12, Goodna nil.
Oh, what a finish. That kick was enormous. Put it up. A lot of height on that one. And, well, unfortunately for Goodna, they couldn't control it. And Heckey was Johnny on the spot and pounced on the ball. And that's their third try. And remember, we had a scoreless 10, 15 minutes. And now we've had three tries in about 10 minutes.
Yeah, unbelievable. They opened up that right-hand side. And it was absolutely... You could see Seve coming through. He did it nicely. And this kick... There are only two tries, converted tries down. This kick is super important in the scheme of things.
And we just saw as we were waiting for this kick to be lined up, one of the players, Daniel Ioni, in a bit of trouble there for Goodner. Looked like there's a bit of an injury concern for him. Let's go down to the sideline. Ben, hopefully you've got a bit more on Ioni.
Well, he's the youngest out of the three Ionis we've got playing on the field for Goodna today. He's full of spirit. We've had him on the show earlier a couple of weeks ago as well. He speaks very well for a young player, and I think it was just a bit of gas taken out of him there. He got up and he started working it out as he walked back into the group there as they wait for the kick from Josh.
It's a bit like me these days. Doesn't take much to take gas out of me, and I run out pretty quickly. Lucky I've got you guys to help me through this. It's been a fantastic afternoon. The rain, thankfully, has stayed away for much of this game because we've had a lot of rain down here in Ipswich. Could have ruined it as a spectacle, but there's a big crowd on hand. There's much anticipation. And at the moment, Brothers are in the box seat. Can they get this conversion? No, it's away again.
12-0. Converted try. Under 12 to go. What about Ben Wilmot on the sideline, mate? This guy, is he auditioning for the main gig? Does he want to go to the NRL like fair dinkum? The stats. David Middleton would be proud of him. Unbelievable, some of the... He's done his homework.
Oh, I'm in contract negotiations with Fox Sports at the moment, just waiting on
good
the final word.
Good luck with that. Remember, you can see all the Rugby League NRL live and free on Channel 9. Underway now.
Just a blatant pluck.
Connors took a nice kick. Turned it back now to Cuss, the number 16. I don't know what you're talking about, Bob.
And if you're not watching it, you can listen to it on Triple M, can't you?
Yeah, 104.5. We're rocking the footy. IRL Grand Final, A-grade Grand Final. Goodna taking on Brothers.
And at the moment, the minor premiers are going to have to dig deep. Oh, here's more yards up the middle.
They're doing it nicely. He's come back on now. AU wearing the number 13. O'Doherty's been strong in this first half. Got the offload, but it's been intercepted by Talapu now, the number 9. So Albert Talapu, and he's got a little bit of a head injury. Slow to get it up. He might have copped the knee on the way down.
Very slow. He gets and plays the ball, and they're 10 metres inside the brothers' territory. And
Salopa.
They had three opportunities early, just couldn't finish off. They need to do something before halftime, give themselves a bit of confidence. There's a good dart from Kirk.
They're shell-shocked here at the moment. Oh, they've made a mistake here. Oh, quick penalty, and they go now. Kirk goes. O'Doherty being the culprit again. I don't know how many penalties O'Doherty's. He's been very good, but Jesus, giving away some penalties early.
I think it runs in the name. The O'Doherty family were synonymous for giving away penalties. Hugh O'Doherty, Pat O'Doherty. I could name a few more if you like.
They are aligned with brothers. So we're back underway now. Salopo, he makes a good, strong carry. Wearing the number 25. Sorry, that's Talapu. He makes a quick cut. They go the short side. They go for the line. Goodna, strong, close to the line. Brought down now, 2 metres out. They work open side, the right. It comes across now. Kirk, double pumps. Goes across now. Tolito, he holds up the number 6. He goes to the line. He'll be held up, though. He will be held up. Great defence, and I think you'll find.
Who's underneath? That's a great tackle to get under there.
I think it's the number 4. No, it's not. It's the front rower, Denimayu. And he's hurt. He's hurt now, Maliki Olato. He went close to the line and was held up.
Look for all money to get there. He only had to twist in the tackle. Great defence. Another opportunity. The Eagles got a couple of set left in this set. What can they do? Can they get first points for themselves here this afternoon? Something before halftime. Big crash, big contact. He's held up again.
Held up again. No, it was the right decision. The right decision. Back to the 10 for a restart. They're doing a good job here, the brethren, at the moment. 8:30 in the first half. Brothers off to a slow start, and then finally they start to hit gear. They lead 12-0. Goodna. Yet to post points, but you'd think if Goodna can get a try before half-time, that might just kick-start them into gear. Shell-shocked at the moment.
Last tackle options. What do they do here? Little chip in behind the defence. Is it too big? No, it's not. They have to knock that dead, and this will be a goal line dropout, and the Johnny on the spot was the number 2 in Ben Sevi.
I'll tell you what, the number 7 in Kirk was selfless in his kick, copped a huge hit after he put that ball on the toe. He's back up. So, brothers now. And when you love a shot clock, wouldn't you?
They take their time.
Yeah, they do.
And here's the dropout. It's a wonky old drop kick and barely gets 30 metres. So, big chance now as the number 5, Watanabulu.
Yep.
He gets to within 20 metres of the line.
So, they work back towards the middle now. Goodna doing it nicely. The number 13, Sormanatafa, as they work now. Long ball, it goes to there. Kirk holds up, looking dangerous. He goes to the line, trying to shoot inside. This is better play by them. And he's brought down now, 1 metre out. Oh, hang on, it's held up. Yeah, he did cross the line. He's doing a good job, Belinda Sleeman, at the present moment. As now they work to the right-hand side, and do they get there?
No, just short. We come back to the open side this time. They've got a line spread out and there's a kick in behind the defence. Is there another chance here for another set? Yes, there is. Brothers take it in goal and it goes dead. Brock Eldridge, he tried to field the ball but juggled it in behind and then took it dead. So this will be another dropout. So they get three lots of 6 tackles if they can hang on to possession here and put a whole heap of pressure as we head towards 6 minutes left in the first half of the Ipswich Rugby League Grand Final for 2016. Brothers leading Goodna by 12 points to nil.
Another one along the carpet, and Wakavalu will take the ball to number 5, 30 metres out, and he brings it back towards the 20. So Goodna with an opportunity now. The 15
Well, we don't even have the number 15. Is Ione? Yes, he do. He's playing in there. He shovels it off to the number 20 in Tau. And he's brought down this big, bustling front rower coming off the bench. Quick play the ball. They head to the short side. No, back to the right to the captain. He charges, but the ball's being loose. It's six more. It's play on. This is where they're dangerous. They catch and pass, and they'll score. Waknavalu scores. Belinda Sleeman points to the spot. They're back into this one. Goodna, 12-4, kick to come.
Oh, they needed that, Dobbo. They needed some points just for the confidence, just to lift the side. We're inside 6 minutes to go now, and the ball came across the back line. There was six to go. There was an opportunity. Good hands in the wet, considering the conditions.
Yeah, and look, it was a mistake by Jake O'Doherty, and it was six more. It was a loose carry from the captain.
And Amu down injured. That's not a good sign for Brothers. They're looking at his knee. He looks all right, though. He says, I'll be right. Just give me a bit of time. And now a very difficult conversion from the sideline to bring them within one converted try.
Plenty of instructions by both sides coming out. And this is on the western side of the field. And Corey Kirk will line this kick up. 25 metres out. You're watching the IRL A-Grade Grand Final on the Phoenix Media Hub along with the APN Network in partnership with the Queensland Times. Hope you're enjoying the coverage wherever you are on the World Wide Web. First time for the Phoenix Media Hub to be doing this, and what a great initiative by the IRL to back this.
Oh, cool. It's fantastic. It opens up the opportunity. It showcases the rugby league. And this is rugby league heartland in Queensland. Let's not kid ourselves.
No, they love it out here. They'll be partying hard wherever you are in Ipswich tonight. Been a great competition. And Goodna right back in this game. Under five to play in the first half. As the number seven, Corey Kirk, lines this up almost directly on the western touchline. 25 metres out. So he pushes it across to that right-hand side. 12-4. And so down to the sideline, Ben Wilmot, Goodna back in this one.
They are indeed. Well, I just wanted to make a special mention to James Haynes, who is the Brothers hooker as well. They picked him up from second division to play today after not playing an A-grade game all season. He's an experienced campaigner, and they pulled him in for grand final day. What a day to come in.
Well, absolutely, because Nathan Creedy broke his...
How would you be there, Bomber? You're retired for the year. You hang up the... So you let yourself go the first couple of weeks after the season.
A bit like yourself.
He's probably had a few skewies, a couple of gaspers, and then they've said, mate...
You're up. You're
on. Stump it out. You're playing.
It was unlucky, obviously, for Nathaniel Creedy with that broken arm.
Is that okay? Sorry.
Now we see, after first points, what can Goodna do now? They've got that injection of confidence. Can they get on a roll here and maybe finish the half with one more? Still plenty of time, Dobbo.
Yeah, they're starting to look dangerous now as they work up that short side, the left-hand side. Lights are on. We've got good conditions. There's still plenty of water on the field, as you can see. Kirk holds it up, puts the ball deep. This will have to go back, and there's run dead. It'll be too much. So, too much heat. You've got to really judge your kicks now. So, it'll be back to the 20 for a seven tackle restart.
That's the danger. You presume that it's going to get caught up in the water, but it skids on, doesn't it? And then you're giving away seven tackles.
So there was a high shot. O'Doherty now. Geez, he's been good this first half. He's given away a couple of penalties, but geez, he played tough now. So the double try scorer, he's been strong, this kid.
Oh, he's been outstanding. What a game. Yards, I'd love to know what his meterage is.
For Tauai now, he works up and he's slow to play the ball. So they're winding this clock down with three to play. They've done it well as they work up the middle. And that was a high shot. It's six more again. No, it's a knock on. And it was Brock Eldridge. He came out of there and he went into the tackle. And there wasn't a lot of value in holding the ball. And Goodner have come in and absolutely slaughtered him. The number 14, Philly Ione, one of the Brothers.
Smashed him, didn't he?
Yep. Scrum, loose head and feed, right on the halfway line. Goodner with an opportunity, 2 minutes 30 to play in the first half.
And this would be a great opportunity, and it would send alarm bells to Brothers who've been in control for much of this first half. And all of a sudden, there's an opportunity out here. And it comes out wide, little step, good run. Still going. What an opportunity. What a run. This is the 17 going. It's Salafoa. He's going to go all the way.
He certainly does.
What a try.
Salafoa. What a try by the number 17, Jackson. And he did it easy. and Goodna are back in this scrum. Well, that's a real bad way for Brothers. Off the scrum, and defence being the key, they'll be disappointed with that. A huge bad read.
Oh, there was nothing doing.
No.
He just kept going and brushing tackler after tackler. They fell off him. And, geez, he showed some toe for a big man.
He certainly did.
Bit reminded myself of my prime Bomber Cannon Hill Stars days.
I never had that, mate. I never had the luxury.
I was only kidding myself.
12-8 kick to come. Minute 20, they'll wind down the clock. And Goodna right back in this one at half time. And gee, Jason Connors will be furious with that. Yeah. That was a huge miss by the number six in Kruger. And they opened it up, and they just would. They went high. You can't go high on the big fellas. You've got to grass tackle them, mate, right around the boot laces.
And you want to stop them nice and early before they get momentum going, because we saw what he can do when he gets a roll on, and that was a fantastic try in the end. Solo effort, and we've got another conversion attempt. This could make it a two-point ball game inside the last minute of this half. And they were coasting, Brothers, at one stage. 12-0, doing it comfortably. And all of a sudden, bang, bang, and we're back into a ball game.
Yeah, Raiders, Sharks, no score after 5 minutes in the NRL.
Who are you tipping in that one?
Raiders.
Raiders?
Yeah.
She's here on a roll. 10
They're
in
going
a row.
Well. They're going well. They're doing the Viking clap down at GIO Stadium tonight. Full house there, 27. It's a full house here at North Ipswich Reserve.
Absolutely. We're doing the Ipswich dance out here tonight.
Kirk comes in. Looked good in the air, pushed it to the left-hand side. 12-8, 28 seconds to play, so that'll be almost half-time. Ben Wilmot and Goodna right back in this one, baby.
Oh, definitely. And aren't the kicks going to become crucial at this at the end of the game? We've had misses from both sides now, and they're not capitalising on those 2 points.
Good half of football, Bomber.
Yeah, despite the mistakes, it's been tough, it's been hard. Couple of opportunities wasted. It's not as though we haven't had opportunities here.
Now we'll just see the word that Ben Wilmot, whether or not he can get a chat with one of the players.
Oh, look at he's on his way. He's out there. He's charging.
Yeah, he is down on the sideline now. He has the assistant coach with him now. Ben Wilmot, down to you on the sideline.
That's it. We've got Wade Liddell, and mate, that's a frantic first half. How'd you feel about the boys' performance?
No, it was good. It was good in patches, I'd say. Mm-hmm. The first 20 minutes we did what we wanted to, and then we'll start doing, you know, a couple of little mistakes there to let them back into it. So something we can work on in that second half. So
got to be proud of the youngster getting a double already.
Oh, for sure. Good on him. Yep. Yeah, exactly.
Capping
right.
off the IRL's rookie of the year.
Yeah, that's it. Good on him. He's a good player, and he should be going. He'll go further.
What's the key for the second half, mate?
Defence. Yep. Defence and just little errors. We've just got to cut the little errors out. Line speed, get up and stop those big fellas. You know, it's going to be a good second half.
Definitely. Well, we'll check back with you after the game, mate. Right.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah, there we have it. Ben Wilmot doing a great job on the sideline. During the course of the week, the team from Phoenix Media went out to both teams and had a look at their training. Here's some of the highlight package from the week.
We're down at Brothers Leagues Club with the coaching staff behind the Brothers A-grade side, getting ready for this weekend's grand final match against Goodna. We've got Jason Connors and Wade Liddell. Thanks very much for coming down, guys. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to be here, Benny. Good to see you guys as well. So.
Excellent. Well, how are preparations looking for this weekend?
Going on last week, we had interruptions after the game with a couple of guys that had key positions injured. So we're just going to do a final couple of fitness tests with a few boys tonight out on the field. One's been definitely ruled out with a broken arm. We've got two tests tonight, and then see how they pull up and start preparing aside for Saturday.
One of their most experienced players in Trevor Exton. Mate, you've played some big games. How's this one shaping up for you?
Obviously, pretty good, you know. It's, you know, they just try and, you know, just expect another game, same mindset, but obviously it's a grand final. Obviously, all three teams are in, so obviously it's pretty hard not to get excited, especially if you get the game a little bit early. So, just obviously just try and calm the nerves and just play as normal as possible, obviously. Yep. Yeah.
You're up against a really big Goodna pack. You've come up against them a few times this year, though, so you know what you're up against. But what's the key for you to kind of overcoming them in the engine room?
Mate, probably just ball control. Can't give a side like that too much ball, so hopefully we can just complete our sets, and that'll go a bit of the way to winning, hopefully.
Yep. Having the week off seemed to hurt you guys a little bit in getting a bit of momentum going into the first round of the finals. Now it's Goodna's problem. Do you think they'll face a similar kind of test?
No, they'll be all right, mate. They'll probably be better off. Probably feel a bit fresher. They've had no injuries, so I don't think it'll harm them too much at all.
Mm-hmm.
You've got a pretty experienced team with a good mix of young players this year as well. Happy to, you know, the group that you've got around you on grand final day?
Yeah, definitely, mate. We've gelled really well throughout the year. Had a lot of new players come in and we're all pretty tight, as you can see out there. So, we're all looking forward to it.
Not often I look up to a player that I'm interviewing, but I've got him in fullback, Josh Leishman. Good to have you with us, man. And I see you've been out there doing the goal kicking. You think you're looking good for this weekend?
Yeah, mate, got to practice to be perfect. So hopefully I can get a few over this weekend. And hopefully it doesn't matter my kicking, that we can win by enough. So,
Well, you were perfect last week, 8 from 8. That's got to give you a bit of confidence going into this weekend's game.
Yeah, mate, goal kicking's lots to do with confidence. So that was a bit of a booster for me last week. So ready to go this week.
Well, you've had a great season at fullback, another great season last year as well. You play a lot of attacking football for a fullback as well. You really seem to like to inject yourself into the attacking plays.
Yeah, you've got to get your hands on the ball, mate, to score those tries. So, I love it. It's better than tackling in the front line. So,
especially up against some of those good new players as well.
Yeah, I try to avoid tackling there.
Well, here's hoping you don't have any breakaway forwards that you have to try and chop down from the legs on Saturday.
No, let's hope not. Don't make any breaks, mate.
You heard it here first. Excellent. Well, looking forward to seeing if Josh ends up shaving off his Dirty Sanchez moustache before this weekend. If not, you'll be able to pick him out of the crowd.
So I'm the halfback for the Goodna Eagles. I've drifted in and out of the halves sort of all my playing career. I spent a bit of time at lock, a bit of time at hooker, but halves have probably been there. You know, most of the time here at Goodna, I played either halfback or 5-8. I've been part of this club for over a decade, probably 13, 14 years now.
I wanted to treat it as a club, not as a team, so that's pretty much why all grades are in the finals and really work on the fitness of the whole club. So that's where I think we've reaped the rewards for the achievement that these boys have done this year. There's not a boy that's let us down. A grade we've used about 45, 50 players, and everyone's contributed to the journey we're on. Yeah, it's been very good. I'm very proud of them.
Yeah, look, we've been fortunate enough to pick up a couple of very experienced players this year, sort of in particular Ramon. So, Ramon's put a bit of emphasis on bringing back the old Goodna culture, which is very family-orientated. It's where you work very hard, you work, for the man beside you. And, I guess fear, we don't want to let the person down, anyone down, whether it be our coaches or the person beside us. So. Yeah, we've tried to build on that all year, and it's working for us. So.
I'm the A grade captain and also the senior club captain. So I played here from under 8s till under 16s. Then I left, went to do a few things, and now I'm back here for sure.
At the beginning of each season, you set a goal to make the grand final. So we've done that, and we don't want to be just making up the numbers. We're there to win. So we believe that we've got the ability and the passion. It's been just over a decade since we've brought the premiership home to Goodna. So we feel as if we're due.
The fitness in the club this year has been outstanding. Every single player has put in 110% into training. You know, we've had a lot of injuries this year, so you know, we have gone through quite a lot of players, but
they've stepped up and done the job. Yeah. The mateship that they have with each other.
Yeah, yeah. They just bonded. They're more a family than a team.
It's been good. We set it up with a good preseason. Got the boys involved. Just after Christmas, and they really took the opportunity of both hands, and we've just been working hard ever since.
Everyone's been behind us all year, from committee to players to sponsors to old boys. Yeah, it's a huge thing for the community.
I think we're
We're going to have to work hard for it. Brothers aren't a team that beat themselves. They make you beat them. So the plan is we're going to beat them. And we think we'll do that, and we think we'll do it comfortably.
Welcome back here to North Ipswich Reserve. I hope you enjoyed that coverage. Half-time and Brothers are back out on the field. And Bomber, I can't pick them at the moment. I mean, I said to you in the half-time break that I thought that, you know, Goodna might come back, but 12 points to 8, 4-point ball game. Right on the stroke of half-time, the Goodna side put some points on, and this will be a really interesting second half of football.
Well, momentum is with Goodna, and if they can go back and dig deep like they have during the season, then they could just about run away with this. But if Brothers go back to what they did in the first 30 minutes of that half and defend,
yep,
they've got the lead, they've got the points on the board, they've got the ability to win this game. So it's anybody's ball game. It might come down to a goal kick, you know.
It certainly could.
Seriously, because there's nothing between these two sides. And don't forget, the Eagles blew three golden opportunities to score.
I think that would be the halftime message, and we'll talk to Ben Wilmot very shortly. But the message from the coaching staff of Goodna, that just take their time. Patience is the key here moving forward.
Well, we're set up for a classic 40 minutes of rugby league, everybody. This is the second half of the Ipswich Rugby League Grand Final for 2016. Goodna and Brothers. Goodna are the minor premiers. They're down by 12 points to 8 against a team that they've had success with in 2016. They've beaten them three times and had one draw in the four occasions they've met. But this is the big one. This is the one that counts. This is the one for the trophy. You take that home, you are the premiers for the next 12 months.
Yeah, we are brought to you at North Ipswich Reserve for the Mayor Pasali Ipswich Rugby League A-Grade Grand Final. The Goodna Eagles and Brothers stream live on Phoenix Media Hub and the APM Network. The call today is brought to you by After the 80. Stream live on Phoenix Media Hub and APM Networks in partnership with the Queensland Time. For all your local IRL and QRL news, follow the After the 80 on facebook.com/AfterTheEightyTV. Today's stream is crewed by the hard-working students of the University of Southern Queensland. Doing a great job. Oh. Taking their time out on a Saturday afternoon. Mud, sweat and cheers.
Oh, absolutely. And you read that like a professional, mate. You should do that for a living.
Do you reckon they might get a sherbet at the end of the day? A couple of sherbets. A good job.
A sherbet, the old band. Bit of Darryl Braithwaite being played out here. Yeah, maybe.
Brothers up the middle now. They work up over towards the halfway line. And they take a short left-hand side. Connors over the halfway. Dangerous, slipping under a tackle. And he's brought down 40 metres out now from this Goodna try line. They're barking for a penalty here. And quick play the ball. They work back to the left-hand side. Open side. Comes across now. Kruger dances around. Put a chip and chase on. It's play on the big number six. But it was beautifully picked up by Kirk. And they're back out of jail now. And here they go again now. Goodna. They're up over the halfway line now. Right back on the attack. 12-8. Second half of football. Brother, the ball now. And Bennett.
He's been good, Josh Bennett, and they're 10 metres out now, deep on the attack. They've got a couple left in this set. Can Goodna keep going? They scored the last two tries of the first half. There's a little kick and went nowhere.
Yeah, it was. So both sides have had poor ends. And this is Ben Sevy. I was saying it earlier, big things about his brother, Marion, contracted to the Brisbane Broncos.
Who, of course, after a victory over the Titans last night.
Yeah, we don't need to talk about that. Referees, geez, Belinda Sleeman, because she could be refereeing the NRL. She's doing a much better job than what went on last night.
Oh, give the refs a break.
Hey, Doherty up over the 40 now. The big, hard-working front rower takes it towards the halfway line. Brothers, can they go the clean sweep this afternoon? Leisman drives the ball down and it's picked up by Goodna, and they work back towards the centre of the field. Still very wet underfoot there. At North Ipswich
away with it. Little sneaky take of advantage of a a refereeing decision, and all of a sudden they're inside Goodna's territory and they have an opportunity now with the ball. This is the 19 for Brothers.
Tolhurst with the ball, 40 metres out now. Creedy into dummy half. They head to the left. O'Doherty goes across. They play out the back now. Are you Connors? He goes across to Leisman. Leisman on the second puts it on the toe and turns his side round. They come driving through and it will be a line goal dropout. No, he's still outside the field of play. No, he didn't. He got there. So that'll be a line goal dropout. So what looked like it might be a little mistake kicking on the second turned into a master stroke. Turn Joel Bennett round. He gets on the ball. They drive him back in. Line goal dropout. Brothers right on the attack.
Well, as we get deeper into this match, it's all going to be about territory, about maintaining your cool, about pressure, and keeping the opposition in their own half.
34 minutes to go in the IRL Grand Final. Brothers leading 12-8.
Goodna now with a drop kick. See what Brothers can do here. They'll get possession. It's not a bad drop kick in the conditions. And it goes down to O'Doherty again, and he winds up and big contact there.
Ran with a cocked elbow. Yeah, he'd be going straight to the match review committee playing NRL. Kruger with the ball, right-hand side. They work, oh, loose carry. Heckey gets it. It's a knock-on. And they just push the pass. Tolhurst, he made a meal of it. And Goodna, strong defence by the number seven in Corey Kirk.
It's a bit of deja vu from the first half. This is how the first half started. A few mistakes, neither team being able to control possession. Goodna now with an opportunity. Scrum packing down just inside their 30.
Yeah, referee doing a good job so far. Belinda Sleeman, the first ever female referee to ever officiate in the NRL semi-final. The Raiders 6, the Sharks 0, 17 gone.
You are keeping a close eye on that one. Have you got a little sneaky something on there?
Not allowed to bet if you're involved in the game of rugby league, Bomber, as you well know.
I was just testing.
So they get a penalty and they ride off the back of this. Now Goodna. It was the 17, Salova, who scored that try. And it just seems to me that Goodna, a little bit of energy at the moment. A little bit more than Brothers. They'd be disappointed with that. A couple of errors by Brothers early in this second half. 8 gone.
A kick to touch towards us here on the Western Grandstand.
40 metres out.
Yeah, 40 metres out with possession. Full set. Here we go. They wind up. They get it to the 30-metre line and golden opportunity here for first points. The big forwards are doing, oh, again a mistake. Luckily, they get away with one there. That could have unwound very, very badly here now. The forwards again punching it up the middle. There's good ground being made there.
Ione.
Yeah. Having a strong game, Ione.
15 metres out centre field. Which way do they go? Talapu, he heads to the right-hand side. It comes across to Kirk. Holds it. Puts a great ball on the captain's chest. He offloads back to Kirk. It's play on. It's dangerous now. He goes to the line, the fullback. But he's brought down now. Great defence by Brothers. Connor's got across there along with Kruger and also the number four. They work back to the left-hand side. A little kick through. It comes flying through. Brothers go. They'll bat it back. Line goal dropout. So Goodna's turn to put the heat on the brethren. Bomber.
Absolutely.
Brothers leading 12-8, 31 to play.
And that's the way you do it, a repeat set of six. They got the penalty, got down into this half. We're lucky to hold on to possession, but good little raid on the right-hand side and then put the ball in behind Brothers and they were forced to kick it dead. And so now we've got a goal line dropout, more pressure. Can they apply the blowtorch here? They need another try to draw level. They've been behind all match. The minor premiers down by 4 points. They go for a short drop kick.
Well, it nearly worked for them. It was Ipswich Jetsol. Seaman Avatara took the ball. So now they work back here. Goes along to Tupus. He holds on the loose ball carry. So they're 8 metres out now on that left-hand side. They open up the right. They turn it back inside to the 25, being Tolopo. And he's brought down now just short of that line. They're on the attack. They swing it to the right-hand side. Kirk holds up, double pumps. Put it on the captain's chest. But the defence there, Philip Owen, he was there. The defence by Brothers, too good at the moment.
Oh, this is good pressure here. And Brothers so far have been holding on. Another chip kick through. Ball bouncing around. It's a bit like a pinball at the moment. I think Brothers have got it. That's great diffusion.
Great defence there. And O'Doherty just fell on it. Oh, and the defence by Goodna. Oh. Rocks on. It was high, though. It was high, but no. They're going to say Belinda Sleeman, line goal dropout. And what a shot on the number 19, Cameron Tolhurst. Well, it's a good lesson coming off your own line half bait. And what a shot by Goodna.
That's great defence, and that'll lift his side, mate. That'll get them pumped if they weren't pumped enough already.
12-0 Raiders over the Sharks in the NRL here at Ipswich Reserve. Brothers, 12. Goodna, 8. Under 30 to play. The short kickoff again, and it was a knock-on. It's been picked up, so that's paid dividends for Brothers. Well, I wouldn't be showing throwing willy-nilly off their own line. O'Doherty with a loose pass. Now is the time to conserve the ball, and they'll get a penalty.
Oh, that's a coach killer, that is.
That is a coach killer.
Honestly, they had them under pressure. Brothers were lucky to get away with a little 10-metre jinky drop kick, line dropout. And then they had them pinned in defence and then gave away a penalty. Luckily, they didn't get too much with the touch finder. And now it's Brothers who've got to roll up the sleeves and punch this ball up the middle of the ground.
So they work towards now, and it's a quick darting. It's a quick darting run. It's a quick darting run.
The 17 now. He gets it towards the halfway line. We're 15 metres from the halfway line, and it's Brothers now got the hard yards. The 14 for Brothers is Trevor Exton. He punches it up, gets to within 6 metres of the halfway line. They've got three or four tackles left in this set. They decide to go wide, to go down that right, left-hand side, which has been pretty good for them so far.
Yeah, they have, and Connors is barking instructions rapidly. Heckey into dummy half. They swing it to this right-hand side. Connors holds up, put it on RU. He in the defence as well, the captain there. Philip Mine made a great one. 13 is RU. They're now 25 metres out. Connors into dummy half. He goes across to Kruger. It's a crossfield kick. They go up for it now. Cuss, he picked up and regathered. Semi for the line, and he scores! Ben Semi scores a great try for the Brethren! They'll point to the spot! 16 points to 8. Kick to come, Bomber!
Oh, what a great display of rugby league. He went up high, still had a lot of work to do, and with two or three defenders around, he came down with the ball and got over the line. Yeah. That is a great finish.
Great kick by Kruger, but Ben Sevi, the number two, and he had plenty to do with it, Bomber, when he took the ball. And he scores a try. 16 points to 8. Kick to come. 27 to go. Ben Wilmot.
Had a chat to Ben before the game as well, and he said going into this game, this might be his last one for Brothers. It's his, he was looking at sitting out on the sidelines for the grand final. He had an injury with his knee. He was out for 2 weeks and just came back in at the right time just to finish off with the grand final.
Well, what about that? He may end up scoring a try in a winning grand final side. What a way to go out.
Well, we all predicted Goodna, and it's a long way from over yet, but Goodna to be the dominant side. And at this time, it's about taking your opportunities when you get them. And what we've seen so far is Brothers doing a fantastic job. Joshua Leisman, the number one. He's been good for them.
And I reckon Ben's got a great sight on this one. He's right behind this kick. I reckon he'll be able to tell us how it's looking.
Lining up right behind it, and it's there's not much to work with, unfortunately. I think he's about a metre and a half out from the sideline.
He reminds me of Pat Welsh at the Masters.
He does.
Talk us through it, whispering.
Well, it's dead centre at the moment. He's got it pointed straight at the black dot. He knows how to get these over. He's done 8 from 8 last week, as we've said. He was at training all week this week, putting in the extra miles. So, and he kicks it cleanly, straight through.
Yeah, flags are
up. Well caught, Ben. Not only does he get the scoop sideline interviews, he calls an absolute corker of a conversion from the sideline.
18-8, Brothers over Goodna. 26 to play. So here's the opportunity now. Can Goodna come back? They need to score next if there's any hope of regaining the lead. Kruger, he took a nice take as well and goes across to O'Doherty. He must love this energy of this bloke. He hasn't had a spell yet, the number eight. He's just put the head down and he's worked. No botcher yet. He went early, Jack Botcher. Do we get an injury up, Ben Wilmot? Do we get an injury update on him, in fact? How is he?
He's still sitting on the sidelines. I saw his arm heavily strapped up and he looked in pain, so I don't think we'll see him coming back today.
No, oh, this number four, Lawyer Fatawi, he worked out now. A loose carry. It didn't go backwards. It's picked up now by the 17 in Creedy. He works towards the 40-metre line, and they're lucky they got out of jail here. Connor's barking for the ball. Can Brothers put more points on? He has it now. Double pumps, holds himself, and he's brought down 35 metres out. Brethren right on the attack.
I tell you what, I'm going to go back down to the sideline, Ben, as the ball goes up. This is a raffle. Let's call this first. Up they go. It's gone. Come back down.
Semi and with the ball again.
No, the referee's called a penalty. I think they're inside the 10. Yes. The chasers were in front of the kicker. Ben, Goodna, under pressure. They've got 24 minutes. They're down by 10. Are they the sort of team that can make this ground up, or do they panic? What's their psyche like?
Look, they've been known for a side that can slack off in the second half of the season from intensity, but they're looking to put that behind them this year. They've done a great job on lifting the club mentality this year, and they've really put in the extra yards at training. They've been into the gym as much as possible throughout the year, and it's really paid dividends throughout the season. We'll see if it works on grand final day, though.
One bloke's just had his pants taken from right under him.
He's a bit cheeky. I'll tell you what. This is the championship round, fellas. I'll give this to the two Bens. This is the championship round and grand final experience. You can't beat Brothers, as now we've got a break coming through from Goodna. Can they convert? They're deep on the attack.
Yeah, great run from Perry Ioni now. They work into the middle, 18 metres out. They play the short side. It comes across to Kirk. The ball was touched out. It'll go into touch. And it's saying it's been touched at. So Goodna look like they're going to get the ball back. It had to be made, though. Bomber, because it was a...
Yeah, championship rounds. Ben, what do you think the grand final experience, could this be the difference with, 23 minutes of play left, 10 points up?
And they've got two premierships in hand already and a second division before on the gala day about a month ago. So they definitely know how to get the premiership on the day. And you'll be looking towards the experienced heads of Jack O'Doherty, who's been fantastic today. His offloads and his work through the mill. He's an 80-minute player, and I'll look to see to him to play the full 80 today.
Full 80. You can watch that as well, isn't it? After the 80.
After the 80.
After the 80, one of the leading television programs on TV. Hard-working crew from Phoenix Media. So now, Goodna, whether it was a high shot, there could be a penalty, and there is. So you don't want it. They don't have the luxury of taking the two. 22 minutes to go. Quick play the ball from Goodna. They go for the line and then back slam.
Luckily, they put him down gently.
They work to the right-hand side now. Kirk, he hold up a long ball. It goes across now to the number six. He worked out the back. This is where they're dangerous. They turn it back inside. Wakavalu, he dances around and spins like a ballerina, but the Brothers' defence, it swarmed like a fat kid to a cupcake. 5 metres out. They work back now. They take it from dummy half. They go there and they score! Daniel Ioni scores to bring them back into this ball game. 18 points to 12, kick to come, Bomber.
Oh, this is incredible rugby league. The game seesawing. Just when you think one team's on top, the other one fights back. That's great football. The short side was a bit skinny. They took advantage of it, and great finish there by Ioni.
So, Goodna right back in this game. 18-12 with a kick to come. 21 minutes to play.
Yeah, let's have a look. All the conversions have been difficult. And, this one could bring them back to within 4 points, which would mean a converted try could win it. So every play is crucial at this stage as we head towards the last 21 minutes of the 2016 grand final, Ben.
Corey Kirk lining up for the kick here. He's been having goal-kicking practice with Craig Werman. He's a former club captain, former leader of the A-grade Goodna side, who won a premiership back when Corey was a player of his. So he's been putting in the yards at training as well. Let's see if he can outdo Josh Leisman here, though.
He knows his stats, Ben Wilmot.
He's a walking David Wikipedia. Middleton.
Comes in, strikes at it now. Kirk looks good in the air. Pushes away, so the score will remain. It's a 6-point ball game, so they're going to have to score at least twice. So now both sides really, Bomber, they need to start playing football. It's not the time to shut up shop now. with 20 to play. We're halfway through this second half.
We've got a quarter of footy left. That's your season. You either become grand finalists or you become premiers. It's one or the other. Let's see what can happen. Brothers kick off and they put it deep into Goodna territory. They're right on their line. They now look to run it out. Good strong charge here. Gets the ball up past the 20, almost to the 30. This will test them. They don't want to give away cheap piggyback penalties here.
Yeah, they work off their own line now. Goodna, they've been good at this tonight. Coming off their own line, the rain. It's very wet and damp here at North Ipswich Reserve, and a good run by the number 14. Philly Ione, one of the brothers. Oh, and they get a penalty as well.
They're looking to get on with it too, Goodna. Referee's in there.
Been playing in a very good spirit so far this game. So Corey Kirk will drive the ball towards the western touchline and bring it 40 metres out. They've had a real glut of possession in the last 10 minutes. Goodna. As now, they work up the middle with the number 11.
Tano, good charge.
Great charge.
Crowds come to life here at the North Ipswich Reserve. This grand final has seesawed backwards and forwards, and now it's Goodna on the attack. They're inside the 20 as brothers look to hang on here. They go wide. It's gone to the eastern side. There's an overlap over there. If they can straighten, they go wide. And they're brought down about 5 metres out.
Wakanavalu, he works back inside. This is where they go, Ione. He slips over now. They're 8 metres out. Goodna, right on the attack as they head to the left, the open side. Kirk holds up, goes to Lemberg. He offloads. Oh! Great ball, and they'll score. They're back in this one. Perry Ione scores off a great pass from Zachary Lemberg.
Oh,
8 points to 16 with a kick to come.
Oh, quality football here at the North Ipswich Reserve. What about that ball? Millimetres from the ground. He gets the arm free and delivers a peach of a ball. And the big forward crashes over. And we could be locked up in a matter of seconds.
What is front rowers doing throwing those kind of balls? You're shaming the front rower brigade. What a great pass by Zach Lemberg.
Well, you wouldn't get it. You wouldn't get a start in Wayne Bennett's NRL side throwing balls like that as a front rower.
Put it under the wing and put the head down, son.
You'd be getting dressed down by Wayne Bennett. Holy dooly. But that was a quality pill. Absolute stunner.
18-16 kick to come now. Corey Kirk will line this ball up. And brothers have had no ball at all. Far from over. 17 to play.
What a grand final, Dobbo. It's been fantastic. Tough, uncompromising, lot of skill, some great delivery. And now we're going to get some finish. This could be all locked up with 17 minutes to go. Here we go. Let's watch this one go through. Can he put it through, Kirk?
Yes, he can. We're going to lock that ball game. 18-0, 17 to play. Strap yourself in. Ben Wilmot, sideline.
Oh, you could hear the crowd erupt as soon as that try went over. What an offload from the big man himself as well. He was on the ground, pretty much falling over as he released it, and he did a great job. Try assist straight away.
Absolute quality ball it was. And we've got just under 17 minutes of play left in the 2016 Ipswich Rugby League Grand Final. It is the Mayor Paul Pasali Cup we are playing for. And this is the pride of Ipswich. And it's been brothers who've been in control for much of the evening, afternoon. But now they find themselves in a deadlock at 18-all with Goodna, the minor premiers. What have they got? Can they keep this roll going? They've had all the momentum over the last 10, 15 minutes. Brothers have hardly had the ball. I don't think we've called them with it.
No, they've had no ball. And what about this bloke? What about the job he's done? The number 8, Zach Lemberg. What a great, strong carry as they work off now. The ball comes a lot to Tupus. He works up the number 2, and they're up towards the halfway line on the fourth. They shape back here. Oh, up the middle. It comes back now. Bennett, he makes a good run. Josh Bennett, he's 20 metres out. He holds, he shapes, he's still going. He offloads to Ione, but he's grass cut in a great tackle. Heck, he had to make it. There could be a penalty and a sin winning here. And there's a penalty. Well, they want to get on with it, Goodna. They play on now. Lemberg, he goes to the line, the big front rower. and he's brought down 2 metres out.
Oh, he deserves a try. If anybody, look at this charge now. Oh, they're certainly trying to muscle up the middle, and Brothers are hanging on for dear life. The crowd, can you hear it, Dobber? They've lifted. They're screaming. They want this Goodna side to get over here. They're a couple of metres out. They go wide. They step inside. And it could be a try. Stepping. Yes. He reaches out. Corey Kirk. What a try. Is this the momentum? Is this the Paul Pasali cap?
Goodna go to the lead for the first time tonight. 22-18. Kick to come. 15 to play. They're number 7. Corey Kirk. He had to do a lot of work. He danced. He swiveled. He shaped. And he got there. And Goodna go to the lead. Strap yourself in. Brothers are shell-shocked. We've got a ball game.
Oh, Ben, how about that? Listen to the crowd.
I'm shaking here, and it's not because of the cold. It's because the crowd's getting off. Fantastic. But what about the work of Joel Bennett from fullback there? He really put the pressure on, and he's got a turn of speed.
Yeah, he did. He did a great job up the middle.
Well, Goodna worked with Mitchell McNamee, was the fullback for pretty much the entire season up until about 4 weeks ago when he went down injured with an ACL injury. So Joel Bennett's come up, and he's done a fantastic job at fullback.
Well, after that individual effort from Kirk, what he needs to do now is convert this to give him a converted try lead. He did all the work solo after Bennett's good work, and now this would be an absolute killer. Where even though there's 14 minutes to go, the psychological advantage they would have, because it means that the Brethren would have to score twice, Ben.
They've had no ball, Brothers. For the last 10 minutes, 15 minutes, they've had no pill. Now, and they're tired. These big forwards, obviously Jack Boccia left in the set in the 16th minute. He hasn't been back. They've been down a man on the bench. As Corey Kirk comes in, strikes at it, flags are up. They go to a big lead now, 24-18 with 13 to play. And is it enough, Bomber? Is it enough? Can Goodna claim their first premiership since 2013?
Not sure if it's enough, but it's a psychological advantage because they have been playing catch-up footy all afternoon. Now they're a converted try in front. And Ben, game on, my friend. Game on.
Oh, I wouldn't be writing off Brothers at any stage. There's still plenty of time left in this match, and if there's one side that can lift, it's Brothers. But having said that, looking at the Goodna enthusiasm levels, they've risen as well. They're going to be playing with a lot of passion for the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, they work now. Tani Lalu, he, the number 11, he works up towards that 30-metre line, and they have to do it. 20 out now. They come now with Tupus. Alex Tupus, he makes a quick play the ball. Number 3 is... how do you pronounce it? Saw Manavatar.
Tafa. That's
he works now. Lemberg. Thanks. Straight up the middle, runs into O'Doherty. Well, there was a shoulder charge. There was no arms in that at all. And Boccia is back out on the field. No, he's not. Haynes is there. So Kirk says, we're getting out of here. I'm going to play it in the opposition half. And Brothers now will get the ball for the first time in 17 minutes. Let's see what they can do. And they swarm on him.
And what about the work of the two front rowers, the two number eights for the opposing sides, O'Doherty and Lemberg? They have been outstanding.
So now, Brothers, work out now with Eldridge. He makes a strong carry, the number 5. Haynes is back out on the field, the number 9. O'Doherty with the ball now. Just put the head down and burrow.
I wonder if they've got the energy now, Brothers. They look a bit tired. Maybe a couple of changes needed here. Defence, good strong run that one. That'll get a bit of momentum going.
They need a penalty here, Brothers. They need to have a repeat second six. Kruger, who has had a poor second half. He put a chip kick in that caused all sorts of curry for them. Joel Bennett had to go back. He took the ball nicely. Can they hold on? He stepped around the first. He beat Connors, and he gets bound finally, and he's brought down. And they just have got the run of it now, Goodna. So they work from their own line with the 15. In Ione, scored a try, a sneaky little dart from dummy half earlier to tie this ball game up.
Oh, he's hurt.
Well, there's no replay, and they haven't got the luxury of going upstairs to the bunker. So get up and play the ball. Good, strong run now as Goodna work up towards the 40. They lead by 6, 11 to play. IRL grand final. They dance and swivel and go, and they're still going, Goodna, as they are brought down finally on the halfway line. The energy, the supporters, they're all on board. Goodna making great metres. And Brothers, they are out on their feet.
What do they do here? They're going to put it up and it'll be a lottery. Up it goes and down it comes. Let's see who's going to end up with it. Oh, there's a mistake. Opportunity here. He puts it on the toe and Brothers get back.
One goal dropout. He made a meal of it, didn't he, Brock Eldridge? And it was a hard kick under the wet.
Now, gentlemen, I pose this question to you. 10 minutes to go, so we're almost inside the last 10. Is it too early to put up a little sneaky field goal and get 7 clear?
Well, it's 10 minutes to play, and Brothers aren't showing anything at the moment on the attack. Do you kick out to a 7-point lead? Short dropout goes.
I reckon punch it up the middle, get to about the fourth tackle and drop a little sneaky field goal over. Oh, yeah, he's going close to the sideline.
Well, if you get a lift, Sevy, he had to do something in Hecky.
Oh, Tanalu, he must be kicking himself anywhere near the side. He just had to go in. Infield, go to the middle of the field.
So, Brothers will get the opportunity. Under 10 to play, 9 minutes 30. Goodna lead by 6.
And it'll give us a good opportunity to see what they've got left in the tank. You've been saying they looked a bit tired. Have they got anything? And can they give us something in attack? They're deep inside their own territory now, just outside the 30.
It was a high shot on Haynes, but he works from dummy half. He had O'Doherty on the outside. Now they work to the middle. Connors into dummy half. O'Doherty makes a great run. He was met by there. Leishman, the fullback. He's up over the halfway line. He's been very good this afternoon. Wow, hang on. There could have been something there, a penalty.
Looked so like now a wrestling
Kruger
league.
Holds on. Oh, there's a high shot on Heckey, and there should be something done about that. Do they get a penalty? No, they don't. It's play on. Sevy, he came in and there's Goodna now. They look like dangerous as they work back towards the middle. And there would have been two opportunities there, Bomber, for a penalty.
Absolutely a chance, but now it's Goodna. I reckon the message will come from the coach. Down the middle, fellas, down the middle. Don't dice with the sidelines. We're in front. We've got a converted try margin. The brethren have to do the catch-up footy. So here they go. Safety first as they push and punch up the middle. 35 metres out now. One more score, I reckon, could just about put this grand final to bed.
In the NRL, halftime, Raiders 12, Sharks 6. Here we've got the Goodna Eagles leading the brethren. 24 points to 18 as Kirk puts it on the toe and sends Leithman back. He'll have to let this...
Oh!
Sammy's knocked it on! And he copped the knee in the back for his measure as well. Oh, they're in trouble here. This could be the ball game here with 7 minutes to play. Ben Wilmot.
If you want to see a stressed man right now, look no further than Laurie Campbell. He's the man pacing around in the Goodna box. He can't sit still at all, and I think all his fingernails are already gone.
Oh, there's a try! That's the ball game!
Oh, yeah.
Max Tormanavatar has scored!
The short dropout did not work one little bit. It went straight to Big Maxie. He did a little jink, a little sidestep. Put the afterburners on. See you later. See you later, Brothers. That is the ball game. 7 minutes to go. They are out to a 28-18 lead.
Brothers are out on their feet. They have absolutely been gallant, but they have had no ball. And the short dropout, well, their drop kicks are, their dropouts all afternoon have been appalling.
No, they've just tried. They've gambled and lost.
That's right. So now.
So much for my big prediction about the field goal. They didn't need it. Straight under the sticks. Yeah.
And Corey Kirk will line this one right up in front to take a 30 points to 18 lead.
And she's taking his time.
She's good night. The Brothers faithful. They'll be commiserating what was a lost opportunity because they did have this game. And mistakes have reigned supreme in the second half.
They led 12-0 with 10 minutes to go in the first half, in control. And all of a sudden, they find themselves down by 10. It's about to be 12. And we've got 5 minutes of play left in the 2016 Ipswich Rugby League Grand Final. And it looks like the Paul Pasali Cup will be going to Goodna. Their first premiership since 2013.
Quite amazing, isn't it?
Yeah. And this, ironically, will be Brothers' third defeat in a row in a grand final.
So, Corey Kirk lines this one up. Big crowd on hand, and you can hear the roar. Let's just listen to this one. The response tells you what the score is. Goodna 30, Brothers 18, 5 to go. Ben Wilmot, are they home?
I think they are, and I think Laurie just lost about 10 years. He was jumping for joy in the box as soon as the try went down, as I was talking about him. Usually you put a bit of a jinx when you say, when you're mentioning someone on the commentary, but it was a good jinx in the end.
And now we head inside the last 5 minutes. Two converted tries in front, Goodna. Looking for their first premiership in 3 years. No mistakes football. Every man that jumps into dummy half is taking a dart. That's three so far that they've punched straight up the middle.
There's more points in this team now. He's been good. Look at that offload. Look at the offload as they dance around now. He's been good, the number eight for the Goodna Eagles tonight. Zach Lemberg, as they shift it to the right-hand side, they turn it back inside. He's been a little magician, Corey Kirk, the number seven. He's just been playing them like a fiddle. He's got the ball now. He dances, double pumps, goes to the outside to the captain of Philippine. They're looking dangerous at the moment, but they'll go into touch. Under four to play, 30 points to 18. We've got to congratulate, a shout-out. The North Ipswich Reserve, this call has been brought to you by After the 80, streamed live on Phoenix Media Hub and the APN Network in partnership with the Queensland Time. For all your local and QRL news, follow After the 80 at facebook.com/After the 80. What about the crew, the hard-working students of the University of Southern Queensland? They've done a bloody brilliant job here.
Absolutely, I top my hat to them. They've done a great job. And this has been an emotional day for Goodna. Bear in mind that one of their long-supporting supporters and sponsors, Ray Jackson, lost his life earlier today. So we had a minute's silence before the game, and they've pushed through that emotion, and they have denied Brothers, who are, you know, the grand final specialists, victory here. And this will be savoured in the Goodna district.
Yeah, it certainly will. What a win for the Goodna Eagles. 3 minutes to play. The captain, is this the last time we'll see Jason Connors playing for the Brethren again? The captain coach, he'd retired last year. He came back due to injuries. He led them to a grand final when everybody said they couldn't do it.
And for Goodna, this has been a real turnaround. They've turned it into a family club. They've worked on discipline. They've turned that club right around, Dobbo.
And it's a good thing for rugby league. Yeah. And it's a great lesson for the young kids coming through. This game has been a credit to both sides. There hasn't been a dirty thing in there. There hasn't been any biff. There hasn't been any back chat. The referee's done a great job. And Goodna will be your premiers for the 2016 season in the IRL.
And Ben, that's a great thing for rugby league in this district.
Work. They've really done a lot of work to turn it around, as you said, this year. Laurie said he wanted to get the thuggery out of Goodna. And that was something they've always been known for. And as you saw today, we haven't had any discipline issues from the Goodna side. They've been very controlled.
What was the big turning point for them, Ben? What did they have to do from a training level? Like, everybody says they turned the club around. Goodna were always known for so long to be the thugs. How did he do it, mate?
Well, look, you look like a club like Brothers. You've got a full gym set up inside there as well. It's a very well-run club. Goodna don't have the same facilities. They've had to look for a gym down the road who gave them all free memberships just to get them in there and be part of the community. And they've all put in the hard yards. They had about 30 players in the pre-season who were doing two extra days on top of their pre-season just because they wanted to.
And I've got to say that this game has been played in good spirit, as we've mentioned, but it's been tough. So, you know, we haven't had the ill discipline, but we've still had a tough, no-compromise match.
So now, she's done and dusted with a minute to play. Brothers, let's see if they can have a little bit of points and they play out the back. Oh, a good Connors. He's a competitor, isn't he? I like this kid as well. He scored two tries at number four. As now they come back and they work back with Eldridge. He goes backwards. Oh, and he's leveled by the captain. And that's a way that fitting, like, just smashed.
And again, Nothing illegal about that, just a good, hard contact.
They're not happy, brothers. They've been outplayed at every point in this second half. And you said it earlier, Bomber. They had the opportunity at 12-0 to go on with it. Two costly errors let them back in. Picked up now as Connors holds the ball. He's 40 metres out. He dances around the head to the right-hand side. Comes across to Kruger. Long ball. He dances and steps. Goes back in. Ducked under a high shot. As the count now comes. Watch the count go. Let's see it. Goodna back. 8, 7, 6.
The crowd will count us down. Here we go.
They'll have a penalty. Jason Connors will go for a penalty. It's all over. It's a long ball. Just kick it out. Waiting up for the Riverheads. Still play on. Brothers might score a try. And that's it. Congratulations to the Goodna Eagles. You are the 2016 IRL Paul Pasali Cup champions. 30 points to 18. They've run out convincing winners. And what a great victory for the community of Goodna and this rugby league club right back on the bill.
And Dobbo, some great vision brought to us by Phoenix Media. You saw the crowd. They are lapping up this success. Brothers known as the grand final specialists, beaten at their own game. And what a magnificent victory. At times, they looked out of it. They looked down and out, Goodna, but they never gave in. And I've got to say, Ramon Philippine, what a great leader he is.
Wow, he was just inspirational. And you're right, Brothers had this game well and truly under control. But for Goodna tonight, the real story is the effort that they put in to come from a 12-0 deficit in the grand final in the wet to run out victors, 30 points to 18.
And never panicked, Dobbo. They never panicked, and they had some great players out there. And I've got to give a tribute to a front rower. The front rowers club never get much mention
Zach
at all.
Zach Lemberg, yeah. How good was he?
Outstanding.
Well, he got them back into the ball game with a pass that put them back in this game. Perry Ione scored the try, but Zach Lemberg, one of their best tonight.
And funnily enough, his opposite, the number 8 for Brothers, was as good in a beaten side.
Ben Wilmot will try and get some post-match interviews. We'd love to hear from some of the Goodna players if you get an opportunity. Get into that media scrum, mate. If you're on the sideline, brother, just push your way in there.
Some great scenes here. Look, there's a lot of emotion. And now the Goodna players are running over to their supporters. They're going over to the far side. And we can see the supporters going absolutely nuts in the far corner. And they're all running
okay,
over.
OK, we got Ben Wilmot. He's got the number 8, one of our cold heroes. He was brilliant tonight.
Well, he gave me an interview on the sideline even as he was coming off. And, boy, what a try assist there as you were falling on the ground, mate. What a win.
Yeah, mate, I'm stoked. Last year we bowed out early in the finals, and this year everyone wanted to draw it, the whole club, and I couldn't be prouder. It means a lot to us 17, but more so to the people that have supported us, Canberra, the old boys, yeah, families that are involved in the club. It's as much about them as it is about us.
Well, they were erupting for those final two tries as well, and being down in the first half, what was it like to turn it around?
Oh, we knew we had the energy and the an attitude to get it done. We just had to tweak a few things. Drop ball was killing us in the first half, so we knew if we could sort of nullify that, we'd go all right.
You started the season with a mission to turn the club around, and what a way to finish it as well. Is this the crowning achievement?
Yeah, it is. It is. It's probably the biggest achievement in my footy career. I've got a granddad that won one in 1964 for Goodna. I know he's up in the stands right now. He'd be as happy as Larry, so I'm happy for that. Yeah.
Well, if you can make Laurie happy, you've done it.
He's been a massive part of the club as well for what we've tried to do, and I'm stoked. Yeah.
Excellent. Congratulations, mate. Enjoy it.
Well, what about that? Look, I'm an old front rower, and I don't want to give up the front rowers club, but was there a tear in his eye when he was saying that? The emotion was fantastic.
He spoke well, and what a great win. What a great win for the Goodna Eagles. 30 points to 18 over Brothers. We'll try and get a quick chat from a Brothers player, if we can. Ben Wilmot going over to talk to somebody.
It's always hard when you're beaten in a grand final. Always hard. And look, we appreciate the players lifting themselves off the canvas. Beaten in the decider is always a tough thing. But Ben's doing a bit of consoling and heading towards the cameras. We'll bring you that interview as soon as he's ready. But we can see in the far side, folks, the Goodna crowd are savouring this victory. For Brothers, they could be proud. They did a great job. Ben,
yeah, well, the front rowers brigade is with another bloke that had a real dig tonight. The number 8, Jake O'Doherty, joins Ben Wilmot now.
From one number 8 to another, we've got Jack O'Doherty. Shattered, mate. I'm sure you were thought you were in with a good shot in at halftime.
Yeah, we were well and truly in it the first half. Come up really strong. And, you know, it's full credit to those boys. They've been the benchmark all season. And, I mean, you know, we really couldn't have done anything else today. So I was just really proud of the boys and just really proud. So, yeah.
You could really see it meant a lot to the Goodna players to get it in the end, didn't it?
Yeah, well, it's their first one since 2005, I think. So it's been a long wait, long time between drinks for them. But, you know, I can't, you know, thoroughly deserved. I mean, you know, no one else really deserved to win it. So they just, you know, wanted it too much and were too good on the day. So
2 premierships for the club in a day, not a bad effort.
Oh, great effort. I mean, the 19s boys started off well with a great win, and then the reserve grade boys getting up as well. So, and our C grade boys won about 4 weeks ago. So, I mean, 3 out of 4 premierships is a great year for the club. And
it was your younger brother Luke lifting the trophy, which was named after your grandfather as well. That's a special moment for the family.
Yeah, yeah, it is. You know, my dad won it. I won it. He won it. And you know, it's a great moment for everyone. And you know, I'm really proud of him and the old boy for getting the win there. So
we'll still be very proud of the team's efforts today as well, and for the whole season. It was great to get here, and it was great to watch you two battle it out.
Yeah. Cheers for that, Benny.
And ladies and gentlemen, as we see the coverage and we wind up today's coverage, can we say we were here at the North Ipswich Reserve for the Mayor Paul Pasali Ipswich Rugby League A-grade grand final, taken out by Goodna by 30 points to 18 over Brothers. And it's streamed live on Phoenix Media Hub and APM Network. The call today was brought to you by After the 80, streamed live on the Phoenix Media Hub and APM Network in partnership with the Queensland Times. Of course, for all local IRL and QRL news, follow After the 80 at facebook.com/AfterThe80TV. Today's stream was crewed by the hard-working students at the University of Southern Queensland. On behalf of all the crew, all the students, the guys who made today possible, the Ipswich Rugby League.
Did bloody well. They did bloody well. They're very, very good professionals in their first go. Great effort, guys, from everybody at USQ and from the Phoenix Media Hub. Rockstars, Bomber, pleasure.
Absolutely.
Ben Wilmot, you are a champion, mate. Thank you very much. Part of you can read him every single day, the QT Times, leading paper in Ipswich. It's the only one in Ipswich. But anyway, he does a great job. From all of us here at North Ipswich Reserve, Goodna, 2016 IRL winners. From all of us here, have a great, safe weekend. Go the mighty Goodna Eagles. Till next time. Bye for now.
And here's rugby league, the greatest game of all.